Okay. My name is Guy, and I am from Swiss Education, from Switzerland. Has anyone been to Switzerland already? Does everyone know where Switzerland is? Where is it? Europe. I'd be a bit worried if someone said Africa or something. And do we know in Switzerland how many languages are spoken? National languages? Four. And what are the languages? French is one. Germany is two. English is not an official language, but it is spoken by a lot of people. So we have German, we have French. Someone said Italy? French, yeah. Germany?
Normally
difficult
to pronounce one.
Italian? No? And there's another one. Romansh. And normally I say, if you get the fourth one, Romansh, I will give you $100 or something. And I said it for many years, no one ever got it, because it's spoken by about, I don't know, 300 people or something. It's a very old language. But actually in Switzerland, there are the two main languages are French and German, and then also we also have Italian, and most people can speak English. So if you are traveling around Switzerland, if you are in our schools, we speak in English. It's like NSC, you must speak English in the schools. So English is also very useful. So what I'm going to do first is just introduce a little bit of the country to you. It's a short video, and it's about 4 minutes long, and it just gives you an idea of the countryside, of the things that go on in the country, just so you can feel a little bit about the culture. Hello? Okay. So this is Switzerland. Famous. I love it. And also I love eating. So if you like food, it's high quality and it's very unique. The spa, also Switzerland is known for spa. Beautiful lakes. And this is Montreux, which is where we are, headquarters. Casinos. Lots of high technology, Rolex watches. The Montreux Jazz Festival, very famous. Thank you. cycle, run, swim, and also even play golf, go white river rafting, hiking in the mountains, paragliding. Traveling around the country. As a student, you get up to 100% discount on your rail ticket. Switzerland makes cheese, and that's a Swiss fondue, which is the national dish. His home is in Switzerland. And in the winter, lots of skiing. Many thousands of beautiful clear lakes that you can go swimming in the summer. So that's just a short introduction to Switzerland. Now, I said Switzerland is home of the Olympic Committee. Question for the sports fans, and particularly soccer fans, what big soccer organization also has its headquarters in Switzerland? FIFA, yes. I mean, it's having a few problems at the moment, but that also is based in Switzerland. Switzerland is very good for neutral organisations because it is not part of the European Union. It's very independent, and it's not even part of the United Nations. That's why many United Nations organisations are also based in Switzerland, because it's very independent and neutral. Okay, so does anyone know the population of Switzerland? No? Okay. Does anyone know anything that Switzerland and Japan have in common? Well, last year was the 150th anniversary of the relationship between Switzerland and Japan. So I'm now going to show you a little 3-minute video again, which compares Japan to Switzerland. So you can see what things are the same and what things are a bit different. Thank you. see something for that. Good train network also. And we are always on time in Switzerland. We never are late for our lessons. Similarities, and the good thing is the similarities are good positive things like safety, clean, good infrastructure, so you can feel very safe if you go there. The big difference is population. What is the population of Switzerland? 8 million. So it's probably similar to Osaka, and the whole of Switzerland is the size of Kyushu. Yeah, so if you compare it, it's a small country. But 150 years of friendship between Switzerland and Japan. It's a long-standing relationship. So, now I'm going to talk to you a little bit. Any questions so far? No? Okay. I'm going to talk to you for about another 30 minutes, and then after that we'll show some more videos, and then we will have questions at the end. And you won't be able to leave until you've all asked questions. So start thinking about them now. Okay? I'll just recap a little bit about Switzerland, and then I want to talk about the hospitality industry. Hotels, tourism, airlines, casinos. It's a fantastic business, and I love it. Because you can travel the world, you can meet people, you can enjoy yourself, and you get paid for it. Then I'm going to tell you a little bit about our campuses. We have different programs on different campuses in Switzerland. And then a little bit about the programs in the schools, and then we'll show some more videos. So, here we go, just to recap. Right in the heart of Europe, next to France, Germany, very close to Spain, Italy. You can take a train from school on a Friday afternoon and be in Paris in 4 hours. So many of our students do that. They go away on a Friday, they come back Sunday night. You could go to Milan in Italy in 2.5 hours. You could take a plane maybe down to Barcelona or Madrid, or you could go over to England. You're really at the heart of Europe. And because Switzerland is very multicultural, people speak French, German, Italian. You get lots of cultural influences. So you can kind of see the French side, you can see the German side, all in one place. So it's a unique experience to have all these cultures mixing. Beautiful country, very safe, healthcare. If you study with us, we will support your healthcare. You don't need to take out any insurance. We will cover you 100% and 80% for teeth and eyes. So again, in case you have a toothache or something, you don't need to worry. As we said, it's the HQ of United Nations offices. Big companies like Nestle, Google, all located in Switzerland. Now, in this morning's session, someone asked me, why is Switzerland the famous place for, you know, hotel management and tourism? Well, one of the reasons is people have been learning about it for nearly 1,000 years. Back in the first century, the hot springs, again, something similar to Japan, the Romans used to travel there, because, and they found it healing, clean and healing. So even then, we had tourists coming to Switzerland. And as people traveled more to trade, in the 8th century, you had to go over the mountains because you needed to go to what is now Italy or maybe to Austria. So you had to stay in a kind of a hostel. And these were the first hotels which came up. Then in the Middle Ages, again, the thermal springs became famous for healing. So the high society of Europe would go there to recover from their ills, the clean air, the special waters. And then as we moved into the 19th and 20th century, of course, the world economy developed, people traveled more, they had more money, and these huge palace hotels were built to accommodate the rich of society. This is now one of our campuses. So from the moment you step in there, it's not just like coming into a normal university, it's like being in a hotel. And we try to make you feel that you are living and studying in a hotel environment. So Switzerland is considered the birthplace of modern hospitality. And this gentleman, his name is Cesar Ritz. He is a very famous person in the hotel business because he developed hotels in Switzerland. And then he went to Paris and opened the Ritz Hotel in Paris, very famous. And then he went to England and in London opened the Savoy and the Dorchester. And he is actually Swiss. And we are very proud because we have Cesar Ritz Colleges, which runs on from his family background. So we still keep alive this old tradition of the highest quality of Swiss management. Now, what really gets me excited is the hospitality industry. When you're studying at NIC, you study hard, you have a great time, but one of the things you have to think about is what are you going to do for the rest of your life? Because unfortunately, unless we get very rich, we have to work. And I can assure you, as someone who's now worked for more than 25 years, if you get it wrong and you pick a boring job where you sit in an office all day long, you see the same people every day, it may not be great. Yeah, I mean, there's many people I've met, particularly in Japan, who work for trading companies. They start work at 8:30, and they're still in the office at 9 o'clock on a Friday night. For me, no way. When I was young, I wanted to travel. I wanted to meet people. And how to do this without money? Well, you get a job. One of the best places or best ways to get a job and travel is to work in hospitality business, in the hotel business, because you can be taken from one country to another while you're getting experience. And I'll give you some examples of that later on. But it's not for everyone. So if you're the kind of person that doesn't like talking to people, that doesn't want to have friends, don't join this business. Because this is a people business. We like people who like to help other people, who want to be friends with people. If you're working in this business, probably you have 80 nationalities working in some of these hotels, either as guests or colleagues. So if you want that, a multicultural experience, great business to be in. Because the business is growing fast, if you're good, you can be rewarded very quickly. So you can be in a management position very fast. You can even get up to the very top within 10 to 12 years. And I can give you great examples of that later on. And the industry is booming. More and more people are traveling. So it's great career opportunities. You're entering a business which is growing, which offers you challenges, not a business where you can't go anywhere. Sometimes people think, oh, it just means working in a restaurant, in a hotel. Of course not, it's rubbish. Yes, you can learn about the restaurant business, but there's so many other things you can do. Front office, the housekeeping departments, You can work in the management side. You can work for airlines. We work very closely with Swiss Airlines and Emirates Airlines, casinos, cruisers, pop music. We have people who have gone and worked for music promotion companies, in media, the spa and wellness things. There's so many things you can do. And you can even specialize in areas like finance, human resources, marketing, revenue management. Maybe you're interested in design. We have a campus that teaches design. So you can go there and learn about designing hotel rooms, lobbies, all these types of things. Cooking, if you're very interested in cooking, you can study about the highest level of culinary and maybe work in a Michelin star restaurant as for your internship. And many other things you can do. So it's not limiting. By studying this subject or these subjects, you actually have many, many options. Who are we? Well, we are Swiss Education Group. We have five schools. We call it schools, but they're actually universities. In Switzerland, we don't call them necessarily by that. So you can come and study with us for diploma, bachelor's degree, master's degree, all the way. And we have seven campuses. So we have two in the German-speaking part of Switzerland, in Brig and Lucerne, and five in the French-speaking part, around Montreux and in a place called Neuchâtel. If you study a bachelor's degree with us, you will get two international qualifications. So you will get the Swiss, but you can also get a British degree or an American degree. And these are regulated and awarded exactly as if you were studying in the US. So you can get an American degree, but it's all studied in Switzerland. We have 6,300 international students. All our students are international. So everyone is on the same level. You will have classmates coming from other parts of Asia, from Europe, North and South America, Australasia, Africa, all over the world. And because everyone is an international student, everyone probably has the same concerns when you first arrive. Maybe my English is not good enough. Everyone is the same. So you're all on the same level. And we're very used to looking after students from all over the world. But each of the campuses, the biggest campus has 700 students, the smallest 250. So it's not like you're studying with 20,000 other students. It's quite easy to feel at home, get to know it. As I said just now, all of our campuses are in former hotels. So this is SHMS campus at Cole. We have many students from NIC who've come here over the last 10 years, just like walking into a hotel. This is Lucerne, in the Caesar Ritz campus in Lucerne, also a former hotel. So from the minute you go in, you feel like you're not just in, you're in the hotel, you're not just in a university. We make sure that everyone has rooms. So we provide the rooms on the campus area. So typically you share with a roommate, but you could also have a single room if you wanted and you pay a bit extra.
But they're lovely, modern, run out. I think it's gone. Oops. I will talk.
Yeah.
They're lovely, modern rooms, all newly renovated, very...
you're connected, that's fine.
Oh, that's a good point, yeah. Then renovated and clean. Put that away. We also provide breakfast, lunch, and dinner. So that's all included in your fees, as are your rooms. So it's not just tuition fees. In the package, it includes everything. So this is actually in Lucerne. This is our students having their lunch or dinner. And this is in one of the other campuses, I think it's IHGTI. This is the coffee lounge. So good facilities for you to hang out in when you're not working. One of the things we're very passionate about is practical. we don't just teach you in a classroom like this. We actually give you lots of practical things to do. And I think that's very good, because in year one, maybe you're still a bit concerned about writing in English, maybe you're still a bit shy. So having lots of practical things to do, learning about what goes on in the kitchens, learning about the front office, this gives you a different experience. So it's a gentle introduction into life in our campuses. All our programs are accredited and recognized around the world. And as we saw a little bit in the video, there's plenty of things for you to do outside the classroom. Lots of events, and I'll show you a bit of that maybe in the video in a minute. This is one of the best things about coming to Switzerland. You can work. So you study for half the year, and then you work for half the year. And you get paid. You get paid around $2,200 every month. So that means that in year one, you study for 5 months approximately, then you go out to work, we will find you the job, help you to find it, then you come back for your second year, same thing, you study, then you go out to work. So it means that when you're working, you could probably save around half of your salary each month, either to spend or even to save and put towards your fees. So it won't pay for your program, but it can help a little bit if that's what you want. It's a unique opportunity. The highest salaries for students in the world are in Switzerland. Another thing that's very important is what happens when you graduate, because you need to get a job. Twice a year, we invite hotels, airlines, casinos, cruise lines to come to the convention center in Montreal to interview you. Our students. So you get the chance to get internships, full-time jobs, while you're still graduating with us. So it helps you to feel that, you know, it's an easier way to start working. I'll show you some videos about that in a bit. But here, these are all the companies that come and recruit. All the major hotel chains, airlines, from all over. And you can see here, this is our students, 2 years after graduating, more than half are already in a management job. So assistant manager, first priority manager. So after 2 to 5 years, 78%, so nearly 8 out of 10 are in management. So you can see that you can move quite quickly into a supervisor role. We have alumni all over the world. Even in Japan, we have a great alumni network. If you go into the hotels, particularly in Tokyo, the top hotels, you will find some of our graduates working there. Some Japanese, but also other nationalities. For example, the club manager at the Ritz-Carlton in Tokyo, she was one of our students. She graduated from HAM with a bachelor's degree. She joined the Hyatt training program. She went to Hong Kong, and then now she's working for Ritz-Carlton in Tokyo. She's 25, and she's the manager of the club lounge. So, not bad, yeah? And she's half German, half Indonesian. There's many other examples like that. So, these are the programs. Each campus is slightly different. So they specialize in different things. Cesaritz specializes in hospitality and tourism and entrepreneurship. Entrepreneurship is starting your own business. So if you want to learn to how to run your own business, it's also a good campus to go to. HAM is more about hospitality and business. And you can do modules learning about human resources, learning about sales and marketing, learning about finance. And these are all taught by guest lecturers from outside. Culinary Arts Academy, I think that's fairly obvious. Cooking, but not just cooking at a low level, cooking to be a high-level chef and maybe run your own restaurant in the future. And then if you're interested in design and luxury brands, IHTTI is the campus to go for. And SHMS, which we have many NIC students on, is very traditional. Hospitality, events management, spa management. People always say, which school is the best? Well, it's the best for you. That's what it should be. So if you are more interested in business, you pick HAM. If you're more interested in learning about running a spa, you pick SHMS. Or events, banqueting, wedding planning, again, SHMS is a good choice. They all have their own niche. So rather than us tell you which program to take, you can pick which one you want. Okay, so I'm not going to go through all the programs on here because that's probably a bit boring. I'm going to show you a video. And first of all, I'm going to show you this, HAM, and then I'm going to show you Caesarez, because these two are quite new videos, so they just came out. But if you want, you can get access to the other ones as well at a later date. So let's show you the HAM video. It's about 3 minutes or so. Shows you a little bit also about the life around Montreal. HAM is in the middle of Montreal.
One, two, three, four, get my shoes and out the door. Five, six, seven, eight, feeling great. I'm gonna shine like a good. I'm doing fine, I'm gonna do it right, do it again, yeah. I look into the sky with all beautiful color, but the love just for me, so gonna share it with another. I got to show, to give, let out. I want to sing and shout, take a look and see a beautiful morning that turns into a beautiful evening, and you're gonna make a beautiful life. And if you wanna sing, then come along with me, that's right. And if you wanna do tomorrow, it's pretty simple, gotta plan on it to follow. And if you do, you have a future real bright. And it's a combination of consistency. Come on, say oh, 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 oh. Just a little bit, move to be free. Keep my head up, don't forget to be me. Like the $1 million, I can get to pay dirt. Kind of stuff from here to here, the kind of makes your face hurt. And we'll laugh, jump, say hi, I'm not afraid to shout about being happy, living it out. Take a look and see a beautiful morning that turns into a beautiful evening. And if you ever make a beautiful life, and if you wanna sing, then come along with me, that's right. And if you wanna do tomorrow, it's pretty simple, gotta quite a way to follow. And if you do, you have a future real bright. And it's a combination of consistency. Come on, say oh, 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 oh.
So that's HAM, and that's the, you know, introduction to life. And it's probably a bit like many schools in a way, in that you see students and things like that. But let me just show you what kind of projects our students did. It's a bit old, but I'm sure many of you have heard of the band Queen, Freddie Mercury. Maybe not. Oh, yeah? Good. It's a bit of a classic. Freddie Mercury used to live in Montreal, so he was very well known in this place. And each year, our students work together with the Freddie Mercury Trust, which is a charity to support AIDS prevention. And it was all organized by our students, this big charity event, and there was about 10,000 people came. So if you come to HAM, you can be involved. If you like being involved in doing things, organizing things outside of, you know, classrooms, this is the kind of thing you can get involved in. So I'll just show you this. This just came out literally 2 days ago.
Freddie Mercury is iconic. He stands for creative extravagance and pure musical brilliance. He inspires people until today. Students from Hotel Institut Montreux and Swiss Hotel Management School in Caen are beginning to organize the second Freddie for a Day festival. It starts with creating a poster and communication materials for the event. 5 teams studying marketing at Hotel Institut Montreux are pitching their ideas. The judges are Swiss Education Group senior management, faculty, students, and a representative from the Mercury Phoenix Trust. Next up was to raise awareness and funding for the festival. Students from Swiss Hotel Management School were at it again. They organized a formal gala dinner to delight all guests, VIPs, and donors. Saturday morning, and Freddie for a Day Festival will begin in a few hours. There is lots to do for the students. They will be serving, hosting, and performing for a large crowd. They will also be getting a message across to the many visitors, one of care and prevention. There was one very special guest present, Jim Beach.
The initiative Freddie for a Day, which was an idea to enable Queen fans all around the world to join together, have fun, learn about AIDS, and help us raising money as well. The important thing about AIDS is that it's the young who will eradicate AIDS in the future, not us. Freddie was a perfectionist. He loved fun, he loved to party. And I think what has impressed me most about this weekend is the superb perfectionism that the students here have shown. They've had fun, they know how to party, but they also know about perfectionism.
The message was clear. Party. Take
it. We are the champions. We are the champions. We are the champions. On the world.
Festival organized by a few hundred students with 150 performers before a crowd totaling 10,000. and with the help of donors and sponsors, more than 35,000 Swiss francs were raised for the fight against AIDS. Freddie would certainly have approved.
The last thing that Freddie Mercury said to me, as he was lying in bed dying of AIDS, was that we could do anything we liked with this music, anything we liked with this image, anything we wanted to do at all. But he said, we can't say that never meant to be boring. And I think for Flora and the SEG, the one thing we can really say is that it's certainly not boring.
Sitting in the classroom, we want our students to go out and do things, organize banquets, organize big festivals. If that's the kind of thing you enjoy doing, then you'll have a great experience also in this kind of area. Okay. Now we have quite a few NIC students at Cesar Ricks colleges. So I'd like to show you a video of Cesar Ricks. There's two more videos to go, and then after that we have time for questions. This is the introduction to Cesar Ricks. It's probably a bit more serious about study and work, but also about your career.
I work in a regional publishing house. We do mostly magazines, about 30 titles.
It's hard work, but if you're ambitious and you want to go to the top, you have your own way, so that's how I got this opportunity in my life.
Build a social network while you're here, because that's what gives you safety.
I run my family business. We have two hotels in Sicily, in the north coast of Sicily.
Well, I'm currently general manager of five-star property in Argentina.
I can go whenever, wherever in the world I want, and I'll have someone I know there, or someone from Cesar Ricks who will be able to help me.
Our students are within 2 hours of Zurich, 2 hours of Milan. All our students are using iPad. All our staff is using iPad. That means that we can provide a very unique learning experience for each individual. We are following the footsteps of Cesar Ricks, who was the true pioneer in the hospitality. We make sure that our students have the traditional Swiss hospitality education combined with understanding of changing trends in the industry. We are very proud to have international partnerships with two internationally recognized universities. Our UK partner is the University of Derby, and our US partner is Washington State University.
Thank you.
from day one. We work with our students to make sure they have the proper operational skills, the business skills, and management skills to ensure they are leaders in their future career.
Right now I'm working on my MSc, I'm working on the Master of Science. I'm supposed to finish this term at the end of this term, and then I will start an internship in Geneva, the 1st of July.
Long-term objective, well, I like to travel around the world, that's why I'm in this business. I want to go work at different countries, and yeah, in the future I'd like to have my own hotel chain, possibly. That's my very long-term goal.
Their international atmosphere in Caesar Ritz, I mean, you can see there is many, many nationalities from Asia, from Europe, South America, and you live for those people, you study with those people, you work in groups together, and learning about different cultures is, I think, very important in the international hospitality industry.
You now have your degrees bestowed upon you, you may now...
Then the most important thing after that is you need to have a good job. So I mentioned earlier about the International Recruitment Forum. Twice a year, we invite the hotels, the airlines, casinos, cruise lines to come to Switzerland to meet and talk to our students in 2 days. You can get internships, you can get full-time jobs. And also, when they came, we interviewed them and asked them what do they want from graduates, what kind of people do they want. So the final video today is to show you about what the hotel industry wants from our graduates and also how our graduates thought about the International Recruitment Forum.
The Swiss Education Group attracts hospitality professionals from all over the world to pick and choose the best in hospitality talent. With more than 50 companies looking for the best new people and over 2,000 students to choose from, SEG International Recruitment Forum has become a not-to-be-missed event by hospitality recruiters worldwide.
We identified about 12 or 14 different hotel schools, and one of them is here in Montreux.
It's a little secret in Switzerland that you are developing some of the greatest talent in the hospitality industry.
And an event like the IRF, having all the schools here with nearly 2,000 students coming through, is a fantastic opportunity for us.
The world of hospitality is glamorous, but it is also highly competitive, and students must be prepared and ready to work in this demanding business environment. Recruiters are very selective and know what they are looking for.
The art is to find the resin in the cake.
We're not always looking for someone who can do backflips and cartwheels.
But there's a few things we definitely look at. One of the things is flexibility.
The ability to respect people.
To get the extra mile.
The ability to understand different cultural backgrounds.
Who are dedicated, outgoing.
Professionalism and also discipline.
Because we're looking for the greatest talent in the world.
Students at SEG schools work hard to be ready for the challenge, and each school helps to prepare their students with the necessary balance between theoretical knowledge and practical skills to reflect the need of hospitality employers.
We create excitement and entertainment in our resort, and that is hard work. Make no mistake.
But you got to be there when you need to be there, especially if you have the idea to be a manager.
There are very few industries where you touch so many different areas. From operations, food and beverage, engineering, human resources, finance, sales and marketing, events.
So it's the most important thing to understand the people that has around you.
The hospitality industry is one of the fastest growing businesses worldwide. More and more hotels are being built across the globe, while others are renovating to keep up with their modern rivals.
Mandarin Oriental Hotel is a luxury group. And of course the most important thing is their employers. It's the driving force.
It's kind of living and breathing what they do and what they believe in.
People come back and become repeat customers in a hotel and a restaurant because of their employers, the people who look after you.
We have graduates coming in who are actually teaching the older generations. They teach about technology, social networking, iPads and everything.
In terms of how we use technology to draw people in, how we're using social media, is just phenomenal.
That's why hospitality recruiters come twice a year from all over the world, each looking for that special someone who will continue their traditions and carry on with innovation. SEG does its very best to provide the hospitality industry with educated and skillful individuals. But there is one thing that SEG schools cannot teach, something we can only nurture.
I think you need to have the passion.
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 It's not something that you turn on and turn off.
I'm just looking for someone with a really big smile.
Generally, smile is the one that comes from the heart.
If you have that passion, you will be there.
And this is probably the one skill we'll be looking for.
2,000 students to choose from, each with different skills, knowledge, and cultural backgrounds. From more than 80 countries, our students are selected and groomed to be the next hospitality professionals who will run tomorrow's infinite hospitality destinations.
This year's IRF was really good.
There's a lot of opportunities from many companies.
Yes, I found internship.
There's a lifetime experience that I'll probably never see anywhere else.
A lot of interviews, a lot of positive reactions.
It's a very good experience, preparing us for the future.
It was really good.
Great. It was great.
Yeah, it was good. Really happy.
And definitely built a lot of contacts for the future.
The International Recruitment Forum proves that SEG doesn't just take care of studies, but it takes care of students and their future. When you're looking for the best in hospitality education, choose the best.
So there you go. And if you come and study with us, don't worry, we will help you to get a job as well afterwards. A good example, just came out. This lady came to SHMS, Swiss Hotel Management School, and she graduated in 2003. She is now, 12 years later, the Global Director of Sales, in the luxury market for Hyatt Hotels. So in 12 years, she's become up to that level. She's probably, I would say, maybe 35, something like that. There's no reason why you can't do something like that. She actually was taken on as a management trainee at Park Hyatt in Chicago after she graduated from our school. And then she stayed with Hyatt and they've moved her around the world, and now she's based in Paris as the global director. So it just shows you know, there's many opportunities for you available. So I think that's all I want to say now. I think I've said enough. Do you have questions for me? And I know you do, so don't be shy, because it's important to ask questions. Even if you think it's not an interesting question, or if you think it's a bit silly, it doesn't matter, because it actually may be a very good question, and someone else may want to ask the same question. So who has a question? Yes?
How much English
skills
for other students are needed?
Excellent question. To come and study with us, you need to get IELTS 5.0 or the equivalent TOEFL, which is around 450, I think. Or you can take our own English test for free. So you could say to your teacher here at NIC, yes, I'm interested to come to one of the schools. Can I take the English test? They will set it up for you and you can take it. But basically, we're looking at IELTS 5.0 level for year one.
And that's
English? English and your high school results. We don't need to see grade A high school results or things like that. We just want to know that you went to school, that you were able to pass some exams, you know, an average student. What we want is good English skills and a good personality. I think that's important. We also will teach you some French and some French or German as a second language when you're there. So you will get a chance to learn French or German. And actually in the second year, you can even pick Spanish as well if you want to do that. So you can learn other languages while you're studying with us. Any other questions? Yes?
You said, like, we can study half of the year and we need to work. How about the winter?
Don't worry, you still get a break. Okay, because the terms are either 18 weeks or 11 weeks, so basically 18 or 22 weeks. When you go out to work, you normally work for 6 months. So you actually study roughly about 5 months, so you normally have around 1 month holiday as well. So let's say if a Japanese student came and studies in February, starts in also, you can start at different times. We have intakes in January, February, April, July, September, October, depending on the campus. So let's say you came, well, most students from NIC come in September. So if you came in September next year, you would see maybe on to the end of January, but you would get a 3-week holiday for Christmas and New Year. So if you wanted, you could come home for a holiday. And then at the end of January, you will go on your internship, probably until the end of July. And then you will restart year two in September. So you get August, a bit like in Japan, you will have your August holiday. So don't worry. We won't make you work all the time.
And can you give us about more activities?
Like sports?
Sports, yeah.
Basically, whatever you want to do, we do it. We have team events, we play competitions against other institutions in Switzerland. We have because we have 5 campuses, we have inter-sports between the 5 campuses as well. So you have soccer, you have athletics, you have basketball, volleyball, all of these team games, plus, of course, many individual things. So don't worry, I should do more of it, I know, but... I'm getting too old. Yes?
What is the difference between
Japanese? It's a good question. The difference between Japanese hotel system and other countries' hotel system. I think the biggest difference is that in Japan, for very long, the Japanese hotel has been catering to Japanese people. And obviously that is changing a bit now, but it's still very much for Japanese, which of course in a way makes sense. But the world is becoming very global. So if you studied hotel management in Japan, you would learn about working in a Japanese hotel. If you come and study with us, you learn about dealing with customers from all over the world. So you learn about Japan, you learn about America, you learn about Asia, you learn different things, because in this business now, the big hotel companies are everywhere. And everywhere you have to try and please your customers. So simple things that many hotels will do, international hotels will do. If I'm the manager of a hotel in Paris, if I know that Japanese customers are coming, I will do simple things like I will put slippers ready for them. I will put green tea ready for them. You know, because particularly older generation, this is what I want. But then after they've left, maybe a different nationality will come. I will change it and put something there. So you have to be thinking globally of what everyone wants. And I think that's where in the past it was different, because you know, the Japanese hotels are only looking really at Japanese guests. But that has to change. I mean, we have the Olympics coming up in 2020. The government in Japan wants tourism to double. So now there's 10 million visitors, they want 20 million. They're going to come from overseas. So for you, it's a very exciting time, because if you go and study and learn about dealing with the foreign guests, and you get experience of working overseas, you can either stay working overseas, or if you want to come back and visit Japan, you're going to be in demand, because the local staff don't know, but you know, because you've done it. I mean, you already are ahead of many people in Japan, because you are here. You are at NIC because you want to go and study overseas. That's fantastic, you know. If my wife was here, my wife is Japanese, and she studied overseas, and she said it was the best thing she ever did. And she wants all Japanese students to do it, but many won't, because it's a little bit, you know, it's a bit frightened, don't know what to do. So you're already doing a great thing. Sorry, it was a long answer. I think you also put your hand up.
No.
I would like to ask you, do you like staying in these hotels? Why? Because, yeah, I used to work at St. Regis Hotel. Oh yeah, yeah, stayed there. Seasonal stuff. Yeah. But I haven't stayed in these hotels. Yeah. So, do you like it? I do. <laughs> I stayed in St. Regis. I've stayed in the Westin. I've stayed in the Intercontinental. I'm currently staying in the Crown Plaza again, because it's also very close to here. And I do like it, but of course, it's important that the staff are good. If the staff are not good, then I hate it. And I, you know, because I basically stay in these hotels for business, for work, and many people do, you know. So I don't have time for things to go wrong. I need things to work properly. I need the bed to be, the bedroom to be quiet, to be clean. I need internet to be working. I need my breakfast in the morning when I want it. And if it's not there, I have many choices. I will not go back. That's why I don't stay in the Westin anymore, because one time they had a big group from Taiwan, 300 people, and it was so noisy, and I had to move my room. And then I wrote to the general manager, and he never replied. So I won't stay there anymore, you see. But if he was good, he would have written back and said, I'm very sorry, you know, and tried to find a way to help me. So that, these are the skills you have to learn. Yeah. But St. Regis is a nice hotel. More? Yes.
And you say the students have a 100% discount
to
all
weekend. A 100% discount?
Discount?
Ah, yes. I thought you meant on the fees.
No.
I'm getting a bit worried.
Is it black hole for a discount?
Yes, no. When you come to Switzerland as a student, you can get a rail card. So this rail card, if you show your student ID when you're studying with us, it allows you 50% off all the time, but in the evenings, and I think it's on weekends, for free. So it's really easy for you to travel around and, you know, see the country. And you can also buy one for Europe, so you can get a student rail card for the whole of Europe. So you could go to, you know, Italy, Paris, Germany, and you can travel quite cheaply. We do actually, because NIC cares about their students very much, we agreed to offer a travel scholarship. So basically, if you come and study with us, we will also give you a scholarship at next year's opening ceremony. It's $1,000, and it more or less pays for your air ticket. And so, you know, I will give it to you on the stage, a bit like you saw this year, some of the institutions do. So we do try and assist a little bit, because we think that NIC is just doing a fantastic job with teaching you to think about going overseas. Yes?
In close to the campus, is there many shopping places or?
Good question, and it depends on the campus. And that's, you know, why I said you have to decide which is the right campus for you. So if you study at HIM, then it's right in the city. So HIM campus is literally 5 minutes walk from the train station, 5 minutes from the supermarket, 5 minutes to bars and restaurants. It's a city center campus. But of course you don't have sports facilities on that campus because it's right in the city. So students from there have to play sport further away. If you are to Caesar Ritz, the Wolverine, it's like in a little village. So you don't have so many shops nearby, but you have lots of space for sports activities. SHMS, where many NIC students go, is up on a mountain. So it's a beautiful location, but there's no shops because it's up on a mountain. But we give you a free train pass, so you can take the train down for free. It takes about 20 minutes. I mean, SHMS Core is beautiful, and it's great, I think, for a new student because it's very safe. There's no one else there except really our students and cows. There's lots of cows because there's lots of fields. So the only thing you hear is dingle, 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 which is the cow, so it has a bell. So what some students do is they study there for 2 years, but then they move to Lausanne for the final year, which is the graduate year. And Lausanne is a skiing resort. So you have a swimming pool, a heated swimming pool, you have ski facilities, supermarkets. So, you know, again, that has more activities. So that's the kind of question also you should ask Tony, because he will be coming to see the schools in August. So he will see most of the campuses, and also Mr. Tate. He has also been and seen the facilities. So it's a good question, because some people like to be in the city, other people like to be a little bit quieter. Yes.
Except business of hotel, what kind of business is major for that graduate students?
Other students, what some students have done is they work in hotels a bit, but then they've moved also into other areas, all sorts of public relations, media, running their own business, even working in a big corporate organization. Because the skills that you really get taught here is customer service. So you learn about communication, how to deal with people, how to, you know, be diplomatic. And this is a big problem for many big companies, is that they're not very good on customer service. So I would actually say that apart from working in hotels and airlines and this type of thing, there are actually many areas, because many of the degrees are business degrees. It is a Bachelor of Business majoring in business and hotel resort, but it is a business degree as well. So there's many areas you can do. And if you want to be more flexible, then I would look at Caesar Ritz or HIM. But if you really decide you want to work in the hotel business, or, you know, tourism business or events business, then SHMS is very good for that kind of stuff. But wide open. I mean, obviously the only things you couldn't do is you couldn't be a lawyer, you couldn't be architect, you know, because those are specializations, but otherwise it's very old. Yes?
Did you show the a profile of the Brazilian in Paris?
I did.
Okay, yeah. That's really interesting. Someone can go so fast, so quick in the industry. She's still in the hotel industry, but she's doing a section of it, the luxury brand.
She's in charge of sales, global director of sales in luxury. So I'm not exactly sure what that means, but I think it means she is the very top Hyatt hotels. She is selling to the very highest level of customer, I think, something like that.
Yeah. So the luxury brand industry is something she could even go into later.
Yeah.
She could come out of hotels, but she's selling something that people want, that people who have money will pay for. So
that's a good reminder. We've just signed a partnership with Hublo. And now Hublo is part of LVMH, Louis Vuitton luxury group. So they think our graduates are also great to work in this type of business. So, you know, Louis Vuitton, Hublo, the Versace, Bulgari, all these very luxury brands, they actually are taking our graduates as well, because what we are teaching is very similar to what they are doing. It's a luxury brand. So Hublo will come and teach our students about how they sell their luxury watches. I mean, many people know Omega and Rolex, but actually Hublo is even more expensive than those brands. So, you know, so that's another option that you can have if you want to get involved in this kind of lifestyle stuff. I also know students who've gone off and started publishing their own entertainment magazines. We have one New Zealand student who lives in Shanghai. He publishes like a Time Out magazine, you know, for nightlife, restaurants, entertainment. So, you know, people can use your skills in different ways. Yes?
Is there another scholarship we can
There is a scholarship for the final year of Caesar Reyes if you are a top student. So there's definitely that one available. I only give out scholarships when NIC tell me that we have to give this scholarship to this student because, you know, they deserve it or something like that. So at the moment we only give the travel scholarship, but we do have scholarships for the best students once you're there, but you have to be there previously. Yes. Good question. You wear your uniform if you are a year one student or year two student, and you wear it from Monday to Friday, 8 o'clock to 6 o'clock, so basically class time. But the rest of the time, if you're not studying, or if you're not, you know, in school hours, you can be casual, just like this. But the reason that we have that is because, of course, particularly in tourism, hotel business, people do wear uniforms when they're on, particularly on the frontline jobs. So it's important. And it also looks smart, makes everyone look good. And so we provide the uniform, you don't have to buy it. It's all included in your fees. Yes?
I just want to know, what are your position? Why do you introduce about all Swiss, all of Swiss cash?
I work for the school, so I am, like him, working for NIC. You know, my job today is to find good people.
But you introduced five colleges.
Yeah.
Which college do you
do? But Nagi, it's a group.
I work for all of them. Yeah. So I don't. I used to work for one, but now I work for all of them, and they're all part of the same group. So that's why we say they're all good colleges. But basically, my job is to find good talent to come and study with us, and then we will then give you to the industry, tourism. I mean, it's fantastic when I see like this Brazilian girl, she's done so well, you know, and I've known students who I met 10 years ago like you, and I thought, oh, he looks like he could be good, and he's come and studied with us, and the one I'm thinking of is now area director of Starwood Hotels, which is Westin and Sheraton in the Middle East, and it's great, you know, to see people become successful. And to kind of identify them when you first meet. Yes?
How do students learn new language? And how to make me practice how it is?
Good. So the first question was how many languages?
How, mostly in class,
language?
Learning a new language in
France. Mainly. Of course, if you are studying in the French-speaking part, you should use your French skills outside when you go to the shops. Maybe you should practice, but we teach you in the class. And in roughly, we teach about 30 hours per week. So it's actually more than many universities. Most universities teach 20. We are more intensive. It's a bit more like being at NIC. We want to push you, and we want you to work hard, because if we don't teach you well, and if you're not ready to take pressure, the hotels wouldn't want to come and recruit you. You know, if you're a lousy student, they don't come because they like us, they come because they can see we have great students. So 30 hours, 5 days a week is what we teach, roughly. So it's quite intense. But that's why it's good to be here, because they prepare you well to come and be successful with us.
Okay, time. Any last question? Anything bizarre, amazing question?
Oh, Nikki.
You said we can get the US or UK degree. Is that the extra study or like?
It's all part of the same program. Mm. So, for example, at Caesarettes, you basically, the first 2 years are common. The third year, to get the US degree, all you have to do is make sure your GPA is more than 2.5, and you will be allowed to continue for that. So it's really about the GPA level that you get. But no extra studies, you know, so it's not like you have to do another 5 hours a night to try and get the second one. It's all part of the same program.
Okay. Some other questions.
Yeah.
If you do have anything that comes to mind, that's fine. Ask through me or get in touch with Guy directly. You'll be back again in
probably October.
November time. So there's another chance to review questions or ask some more. But think it over. I mean, it's different option than America. It's Europe. Europe is big. It's a Switzerland, which is right there in the middle. As we heard, traveling is something you can do very easily, and sponsored by the Swiss government itself. So it's a nice option. And an international thing, the students you study with will be connections, as we heard in the video, it's a network. You're creating a network for life, people to go to, people who you can rely on. Very interesting. Thank you very much.
Thank you.